Let us discuss error detection with parity check. A simple parity check code is a single bit error detecting code in which n is equal to k plus 1. That means if we have k number of data bits, then you can add one extra parity bit so that we will be transmitting k plus 1, that is n number of bits. And with d min is equal to 0, that means in the data there should be at least two bits. So we are going for the parity check. Now see, here we are having the data words. So how many bits are there in the data words? 4 bits. So we shall add 1 bit extra. So ultimately we shall have our 5 bits. So here you see, here we have considered this one as odd parity. That means here we have considered this one as even parity rather, because here you see even parity means total number of 1 including in the message and the parity bit should be even. Always remember. So how many 1s are there? 0 number of 1. So I am adding another 0 here as a parity bit. So the total number of 1 has remained 0. That means even number of. Here how many 1s are there? Only 1. So that's why I am adding another 1. So the total number of 1 in the message and the parity bit will become 2. That is the even number. So how many bits are there? 1. Only 1. So I am adding another 1 bit. So 2 1s. So in this way, how many bits are 1 here? 2 ones, so I shall be putting 0 there, so that the total number of bits in the message and the parity bit including will be 2, that is the even number of. So this is known as even parity. In this way, 4 bits can have 16 different combinations. So we have written this one from 0 to 7 and then 8 to 15. So 16 different combinations from 0 to 15 here, and for each one of them we have developed the code words. So now let us see this one. So encoder and decoder for simple parity check code. Just see here, here we are having the data code. So this is the data word rather. So these data words, how many bits are there? 4 bits. So this is the parity generator, and this particular parity generator will generate a parity bit, and these bits will be there, and that is the code word we are having. So from the data word, after adding this parity bit, we are getting this code word, and that will be transmitted through some, say, unreliable transmission. So now what will happen, from this received data bits, the checker will produce the respective parity bit. So from this data bits received, and then it will be checked, the last bit will be checked with this. So that will produce a syndrome. Syndrome means the received parity bit, that is from the received data bits, we are going to produce the parity bit in the same logic. If we have applied the even parity here, there also will be getting the even parity there. Then the parity bit will be XORed with this received parity bit. So syndrome will be produced, and that will decide whether this particular data is correct or wrong, and accordingly either it will be accepted or it will be rejected. If the things are not clear to you, I can repeat here. Let us suppose here we are having, say, 0, 0, 0, 0. So the even parity will be 0 here. Let us suppose I have got 0, 0, 0, 1 and the received parity bit is 0 there. So from 0, 0, 0, 1, the parity checker will produce the parity bit 1. So that 1 and this 0 will produce, after doing the XOR, will produce 1, and that will indicate that these particular bits have got corrupted. So these bits will be rejected at the receiving end. But otherwise, if the syndrome is 0, in that case, the data will be accepted in that case. So data word will be retrieved by discarding the parity bit. So a simple parity check code can detect an odd number of errors. So if bit corruption takes place in odd number of places, I'm not talking about odd place number, in odd number of places, then the parity bit can detect that one. But if the bit corruption takes place for even number of places, then parity bit cannot detect that error. So this is the way in which the parity check can work. Now let us go for the next one, where we are having the two-dimensional parity check code. So here we are having our data set. This is the data we are having. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 bits. So in this way, we are having 4 words, and we are calculating the row-wise parities. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So in case of even parity, I shall be putting 1. In this way, the row parity bits have got formed. And similarly, considering the column, here we are having 2 ones in this column. So the parity bit will be 0 if you consider the even parity. So here this column parity bits will be formed. Row parity bits have been formed. So now this particular block will be transmitted now. Now deriving row and the column parities. Now if we consider the single bit and double bit errors in two dimensional parity, then what will happen? In case of single bit error, if the bit has got corrupted, then what will happen at the receiving end? So here we are having this one here, and this particular bit has got corrupted, but I am receiving here 0. That means this bit has got corrupted, it has been made say 0 in that case, complemented. So what will happen? This row wise parity bit and this column wise parity bit can detect that error, because this bit corruption has taken place at this particular place. So let me go to the previous slide. So here it is our 1011101. So here in this case 1011101, that means after corruption this bit will become 0 because it will get complemented. So now if you consider this one as 0, at the receiving end if you calculate the column parity for here, you will be getting 1, so it is differing. And if you calculate the row parity here, so it is 1111, so 41, so I will be the parity bit will be 0. So here also you will be getting one mismatch. So from this row and column intersection, you can find the victim bit which got corrupted during the transmission. So also you can correct that one because you are getting the respective place. But what will happen in case of 2 bits place error? So whenever you are having 2 bits place error, then this particular row cannot detect that one, the row parity bit, because even parity or parity bit cannot be affected if there are errors occurred in even number of places. But this column and this column will detect that is a corrupted bit is existing in any one of the rows of this column. So in this way 2 errors affects and there is a 2 parities. Now if you consider this very particular diagram here, this particular case study, so here we are considering 3 bits error. That means this and this 3 bits have got corrupted at the receiving end. Then how many parity bits are getting affected? So this parity bit will be affected because I can calculate the new parity bit in that case. So it will be, but not along this particular column. Why? Because we are having even number of errors in this respective column. So for the 3 error affects 4 parity bits here. Now here you see the bit corruption has taken place in such a balanced way. If you consider this particular row, so even number of bit corruption take place, even number of bit corruption has taken place. For this column, even number of bit corruption, even number of bit corruption has taken place. So 4 error cannot be detected in this particular case study. So in this way, we have discussed that how this parity bit check can enable us to detect errors. And in some cases also, we will be finding ourselves in a situation where the error can also get corrected at the receiving end. Thanks for watching this video.
Tutorialspoint.com. Simply easy learning.